Hi, my name is Nick Bronn. I use Qiskit for quantum computing research and education. Today, we're going to talk about installing the development branch of Qiskit. You'd be interested in doing this if you're a researcher who wants access to the latest and greatest tools in Qiskit. Or maybe you're a software developer who wants to build onto Qiskit. Or maybe you're some combination of both. Either way, you want to live on the bleeding edge of what Qiskit has to offer. In a previous video, we covered installing Qiskit for users. That included topics like registering for an IBM quantum account and running Jupyter Notebooks. Today, we'll focus on installing Qiskit for developers. This video will also include some basic tips for open source software development. I came to quantum computing from a physics background, so these are some of the things I picked up from contributing to Qiskit. Let's start by downloading the Anaconda version of Python. Navigate to anaconda.com, click on Products, and download the individual edition. Follow the install instructions. Next, open up a terminal or Anaconda prompt. Let's manage our conda environments. We can see what we have by typing in conda env list. I'm a busy guy, I've got a lot of environments, so let's create a new one for development. Type in conda create-n for name, qiskit-dev, let's say, and install the latest version of Python. Hit yes when asked. This will take a moment to install. Now, we need to get set up with GitHub. Let's go to github.com. Create an account if you haven't already. Next, navigate to github.com/Qiskit. Click on Qiskit Terra, which is the foundation of which the rest of Qiskit is built. Instructions for installing the other Qiskit modules can be found in the link below. In order to make a contribution to Qiskit, you must fork a copy for yourself. So navigate to the upper right and click on the fork button. I've already forked Qiskit Terra, but for you, this will take just a moment. You'll arrive at your own copy of Qiskit Terra that you control. It's through this version that you'll be able to make contributions to Qiskit. If you haven't already, you need to add an SSH key to your GitHub account. Click on your profile, settings, SSH and PGP keys, and add your SSH key. If you need instructions on generating an SSH key, please see the link below. Navigate back to your forked Qiskit Terra repo. Click on the code button and make sure you have SSH selected under clone. Copy the address and navigate back to your terminal. Back at the command line, we want to activate our Qiskit dev environment. Conda activate Qiskit dev. Now we want to clone the web address we just copied. Git clone paste. This will just take a moment. Objects are being received. They have been enumerated. They have been resolved. And we're good. Change into your Qiskit Terra directory. Cd Qiskit Terra. While most of Qiskit Terra is written in Python, some core routines are written in Rust. This can easily be installed by navigating to rustup.rs and following the instructions. For Unix-based operating systems, including Linux and macOS, it's as easy as running this command. For Windows installs, you'll need to download an executable, as well as install the latest build tools for Visual Studio, linked to in the description. Proceed with installation. We can restart our terminal or source our environment for Rust. Next, install the required libraries. Pip install-r requirements.txt. Collecting things. And let's go ahead and install the developer libraries, so we don't have to worry about that later. Pip install-r requirements-dev.txt. Next, we'll install a Python kernel for using Qiskit inside Jupyter Notebooks. Python-m ipy kernel install dash dash user dash dash name Qiskit dev, we'll use the same name as our environment, dash dash display name, and we'll call that Qiskit dev as well. And that just takes a second. And then finally, we'd also like to install Rise so we can view Jupyter Notebooks in slideshow format. Pip install Rise. Next, we'll set up the GitHub environment. First, we'll do remotes. This allows us to get updates from Qiskit's repo and merge them with our fork. To see what our remotes are, type in git remote-v. Currently, we can see we have origin, which is our forked copy on our own GitHub account. But we need to know where Qiskit lives, so we need to add an upstream so we can merge with our own local copy. We do this by typing git remote add upstream git at github.com colon Qiskit slash Qiskit dash Terra. Now we can go back and look at our remotes by typing in git remote dash v again. Now in addition to origin, we have upstream, which allows us to pull or fetch the latest updates from Qiskit into our own local copy. We can do this by git pull upstream main. Main is the name of the default branch. And we're up to date. Now let's push these updates to our origin on our github.com account. Git push origin main. And we're up to date. Next, let's create a feature branch and do some work. Git checkout dash b, which will create a new branch, and we'll call it my feature branch. Let's do some work. Some work. Now let's see what changed by typing in git status. I have some work. I can add it to my repo. Git add work. Now I can commit my changes by doing git commit dash m some awesome work. And now I can push that to my origin. Git push origin my feature branch. That was a fake example of a code contribution. Let's go to one I've actually been working on. Git checkout template param expression. There we are. First, let's make sure we're up to date with the latest dev branch. Git pull upstream main. Now, there are some important things to do before submitting the pull request. If you've added new features, add some release notes to document what you're changing. Reno new add parameters to template substitution dash dash edit. Here, we add the features we wish to contribute to Qiskit. My example involves using circuit parameters in a new transpiler pass called template optimization. That saves the release notes in our working branch. Now we need to perform some code checks. Tox is a tool to standardize code testing in Python, and we use it to run code checks before submitting the pull request. We'll start with tox-eblack, where e refers to the current environment, and black is a tool that automatically fixes whitespace and formatting errors. That took a little while because we had to build our Tox environment because we're starting from a fresh install. If you need to rebuild your Tox environment, use dash -r. Next, we'll do tox-elint-incr. Lint checks your code for programming and style errors, and incr for incremental just checks the files you modified instead of all of them. Does that sound good? Okay. Then we just wait for a sec. And finally, type in tox-epy. This will run unit tests on all of Terra for the current version of Python. These code checks can take a while, so it might be a good time to stretch your legs. Now that the checks have passed, we're ready to submit our pull request. Let's add the change files to the commit by typing git add capital A. Add our commit by doing git commit -m added release notes and fixed toxlint issues. And finally, we'll push to our copy on github.com. git push origin template param expression. Enter. Next, go to github.com and select the branch that you would like to submit a pull request for. Ours is called template param expression, but we're already in the middle of a pull request here, so let's go to our fake feature branch, my feature branch. In order to start a contribution, click on the contribute button and click on open pull request. Here you can fill out details such as relevant issues, other relevant pull requests, and information regarding what you're trying to contribute. And then click on create pull request below. Note your pull request must pass all the continuous integration checks before anything else happens. Make sure you read the contributing guidelines and the code of conduct found in the description below. Now you've just made a pull request to Qiskit, but it's not over yet. Your code will be reviewed by core Qiskit developers. This is a collaborative process, the keyword being process. It might take a few rounds of review, but you will receive useful feedback and you're free to post in Slack with specific questions. And eventually, your code should be merged into Qiskit. So that's how you install and contribute to Qiskit as a researcher or developer. I've been your host, Nick Bronn, and I hope you enjoyed this video and found it useful. If you have any questions, please let us know in the comments. Thanks again for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe for all things Qiskit.